The Mass of June the 12th, I guess it's a little after midnight, but the Mass of June the 12th, and the St. John the Kunda. And the, we read here only the Gospel. Do you understand the Gospel? Read only the Gospel. Which signifies according to St. Luke chapter 12. At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, "Let your loins be girt and lamps burning in your hands. And you yourselves like to men who wait for their Lord when he shall return from the wedding, that when he cometh and knocketh, they may open to him immediately. Blessed are those servants whom the Lord, when he cometh, shall find watching. Amen, I say to you, that he will gird himself and make them, he will gird himself going down to find them, open immediately, he shall return from the wedding, and then when he cometh and knocketh, they have opened to him immediately. Blessed are those servants whom the Lord, when he cometh, shall find watching. Amen, I say to you, that he will gird himself, and make them sit down to meat, and passing will minister unto them. And if he shall come to this in the second watch, or come in the third watch, and find them so, blessed are those servants. But this know ye, that if the householder did know it, at what hour the thief would come, he would surely watch, and would not suffer his house to be broken open. Be you then also ready, for at what hour thou thinkest not, the Son of Man will return, will come. Those are the words of today's Holy Gospel. In the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, Amen. As we prepared for the Lord when he comes, in the middle of the night, and of course, you know that the night, we are living in the night right now. We're living in the night because this world is obviously in a state of great sin, and the world is dark to the things of God, knows nothing of the things of God, and that this world has rejected God, and not only that, but we are preparing for the new world order, the order of the coming of the Antichrist, a world that is going to be completely not only without God, but completely against God in every way. And that there, all those who think of God, all those who think anything of the law of God, they are going to be put to death, they're going to be put to all manner of suffering, and they're going to be let known that that if you don't, if you go along with any of the law of God, any of the laws of God, that's the law of simply having a Catholic family, a large family, the law of simply staying in a Catholic marriage, in one marriage, the law of going to practice the faith in public, all these laws are going to be taken away from us in the night. And as it's taken away, people are going to try to be comfortable, and they're going to try to find a way to survive in the night. But what does our Lord say? Blessed is that servant that watches in the night. When you watch in the night, one of the dangers of the night, of course, when one of these he gets tired and falls asleep, and he loses his attentiveness. What are we supposed to be attentive to? We are in a night, which right now we're in the physical night, we're in the middle of the night, but also we're in the night of this whole world. In the night, one loses attentiveness. In the night, one can't see very clearly. In the night, one tends to fall asleep. And that this is the danger of the world right now, that the souls who are the friends of God, the souls who have the Catholic faith, these souls are in grave danger of falling asleep. And that they are not watching in the night. But our Lord said, blessed are those servants who watch in the night. And when the Christ comes in the midnight watch, and he finds those servants watching, he will minister to them. He will be the one to feed them. He'll be the one to take care of them. He'll be the one to be the waiter at the table. He'll be the one to take care of those that are watching for him. And if he comes in the second or third watch, blessed are they. Because it's hard to watch at midnight. It's harder to watch at the second watch. It's harder to watch at the third watch. And so blessed are those that watch. Now, what are we attentive to in these times of trouble? One of the great temptations of the devil is to be overly attentive to the troubles. We have to be aware that there are troubles around us. They're trying to make a one world government. They're trying to destroy our country. They're trying to destroy all Christianity, what remains of Christianity, what remains of the Catholic religion, our culture. They're trying to make us legally and in every way slaves of a new one world government. And we see the terrible things happening all around us, and we begin to be afraid and to be distracted by these things. On the one side, we should be of a certain awareness. The devil is trying to take over this world and prepare for the Antichrist. But we also know by our faith that this is not yet the time of the Antichrist. It's not yet that time. It is going to be the time of the victory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, but very much like unto the time of the Antichrist. And yet their souls are very easily tempted to worry about the communists and the infiltrators and all those who are trying to take over the world. But whether there should be a certain amount of awareness, this is not our concern. Our Lord said, watch. What are we watching for? In the middle of the night, what is going to happen? Christ is going to come. Christ is going to come. He comes on the day of our judgment, the day of our death. He comes to the death of our country. He comes to the death of our family. He comes to the death of our city. He comes to the death of the world. Christ is going to come. And Christ is going to judge. And Christ is going to have another victory before the end of the world. And this victory is about to come upon us at any time. We do not know the time. But what are we supposed to be watching for? Usually when you're in the middle of the night, the man who watches, he says, if they knew the hour the thief would come, he would watch. Our Lord Jesus Christ comes as a thief in the night. You don't know when he's going to come, but he is not a thief. When we see this man come, we open the doors. When you see a thief come, you lock the doors. When you see a thief come, you shoot the thief. But he will come as a thief. He's going to come unannounced. He's going to come when we least expect it. He's just going to show up at some time, maybe earlier than we expect, maybe later than we expect, but he will not come at the time we expect. That's the only thing we know. At the time you think not, that is when Christ is going to come. So if you think he's not going to show up on time because he's always late, then he might show up on time. But the fact is, he will always come at a time at which we think not. That's much we know. Therefore, we must always be ready. But what are we supposed to be ready for? When you look at the lives of the martyrs and the lives of the saints, as St. Stephen was on his way to be stoned to death, the very first martyr, as St. Stephen was on his way to be stoned to death, what did he see? As he was on his way to his death, he looked up into heaven and he saw the clouds opened and he saw Christ and he saw a most beautiful vision of the angels. And he began to speak of the beautiful thing that he saw, and he began to speak of the beauty of heaven and of the Christ that he saw. And then the people stopped up their ears. They screamed with a loud voice because they didn't want to hear what St. Stephen had to say. They then with great haste took him out and stoned him to death, and he became a martyr. And the same is true of all the martyrs. What are they looking for? They are looking for the Master. They are looking for him who is to come. They're waiting for him without waiting for anything else. And St. John was a great example of this. St. John Vicunda, a saint in the 1500s, always preaching against the sin and preaching against the corruption in the church and preaching against the heretics. And he lived such a virtuous life and great penance and so on, and converted many back to God. So many converted back to God that they wanted to kill him many times. But St. John never paid attention to them. And there are so many miracles in St. John's life that, for instance, soldiers would come to kill him. And as they went to kill him, their arms would freeze. And they couldn't move their arms. And they were frozen in place, unable to move and paralyzed and in a state of total fear. And they remained in that state until they decided to repent and lay down before his feet and beg forgiveness. And it happened to so many. So St. John paid no attention to them whatsoever. He was going about preaching in the night. He was going about visiting souls in the night. And they would come to kill him and come to kill him and come to kill him. He did not die a martyr. It was not God's will that he die a martyr. But the many, many, many times they wanted to martyr him. And every single time, the person that went to martyr them, or the several that went to martyr them, they were frozen stiff and unable to move and filled with terror when they came in the presence of St. John, who didn't pay any attention to them but went about his duty, celebrating Mass, preaching the sermon, or taking care of the sick, or whatever he was doing. He paid no attention to them. And they froze in fear. And then when they repented, then he paid attention to them. And he forgave them their sins. And this must be our spirit in the middle of the night. We are in a great night. We are in a great night of the world, a great night of tribulation, a great night of all manner of difficulties. But what are we supposed to do? Wait for the coming of Christ. Look for the coming of Christ in his victory. Look for the coming of Christ in his glory. Because he is going to have his victory and he is going to have his glory. And this glory is that which we are supposed to be waiting for. And that is why Christ says, blessed are those whom he finds watching at midnight. Not watching for the thieves, but watching for Christ. Blessed are those that he finds watching at the second and third watch. That even the second and third watch, as the darkness of the night is getting worse, as the length of the night is getting longer, as the terror of the night is becoming more, that we are not distracted by the terrors of the night. We are not supposed to be distracted by the attacks of the Masons and the attacks of the Bilderbergers and the attacks of our enemies all around us. On the one side, there should be a certain awareness and a certain bit of a combat against them. But our expectation and our eyes look to the coming of Christ in the night. And he will come in the night. He will come. And when he comes and finds us watching, he will minister unto us. And the victory will be great indeed. So in any case, we'll close it at that in this Mass in the middle of the night. And so in any case, to pray that we are found watching for Christ in the night and not watching for other things. And close it. God bless you all. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen.